Gonzaga could not do a damn thing. Baylor did the damn thing, and they did it all damn night. Again, they knew Gonzaga was gassed, so they wrapped both their hands around their throats, and they choked them the hell out. At one point in the first half, it was 29-10 in the national championship game against an undefeated Gonzaga team looking to make history. I mean, you just know somewhere Mercury Morris was popping champagne at that point. Just because. Listen, Baylor deserves all the credit in the world for what they did last night. That was as impressive a beatdown as you're ever going to see in a national championship game. And the really wild thing to me is, it was not that long ago that these guys were still trying to find themselves. It was not that long ago that they were trailing Villanova by 7 at halftime of the Sweet 16. Jared Butler, who couldn't miss in a Final Four, barely made a third of his shots in the first four tournament games, and he was even worse from deep. But when it mattered most, against Houston and Gonzaga, he knocked in nearly 60% of his threes, and some of them were even coming from Steph Curry range. And when you see that guy hitting shots like that, and then the juice that he was providing on defense and offense, it's no surprise that he was the most outstanding player of the Final Four. But as good as Butler was, I have no problem if they had given it to Davion Mitchell, if he had been MOP. Butler was a walking bucket. Mitchell was a walking clamp. He didn't put up as many points as Butler, but he had 16 assists in the Final Four. He was lights out on defense. And if you want somebody who sums up Baylor's defensive attitude and mindset, it's Mitchell. And one more thing that's really important to discuss. Do not for a second disrespect Baylor or Gonzaga by coming up in here and saying that the Zags were overrated, or by coming up in here and talking junk about Gonzaga. That is a damn good team. A damn good Gonzaga team with multiple NBA players on their roster, including a guy who's a likely top 5 pick in the next few months. They were the number one team in the country from preseason until last night. And I don't want to hear about their conference either. They beat Kansas. They beat West Virginia. They beat Iowa. They beat Virginia. They beat 5 straight teams in the tournament, and most of them never even laid a hand on the Zags. Until Baylor. Because that's how good Baylor is. So if you want to come in here and you want to take a run at Gonzaga or Mark Few, man, just keep moving. Keep moving. I've got no time for that today or tomorrow or really ever. Last night was not about Gonzaga not being good or being overrated or playing in a bullcrap conference. No, what that is a bullcrap attempt to get somebody to look at you. It's not about that. It's about how good Baylor was. Dumping on Gonzaga is disrespecting Baylor. Don't do it, because Gonzaga did not get exposed last night. They did what Houston did 2 nights earlier. They ran into a bleeping buzzsaw. Baylor led Houston by 25 at halftime. They were up by 19 on the Zags in the first half. They're just that good. Baylor is just that good. It's not a case of Houston and Gonzaga being that bad. It's a case of Baylor being that good. So, the issue is not that people overrated Gonzaga. It's that people underrated Baylor badly. Because as much respect as everybody gave them before that game, it still was not nearly enough. And they ripped a ton more last night. And the fact is about Baylor, had they not gone on that pause midseason, we'd probably be talking about them being the first undefeated champion since 76 instead of the Zags. And talking them up as a potential generational team. Hell yes, Baylor fans were lighting bleep on fire in Waco. I see them working. They had a hell of a lot to celebrate and a hell of a lot to burn after the season they just had. I mean, myself, I almost went gaucho style and burned a couch on their behalf. That's how impressive Baylor was last night. Extremely impressive on both ends. With their energy, their aggression, their length. Really impressive. Let's get some reaction in here quickly. Chris, no longer in St. Pete, tweets, Baylor made Gonzaga look like a bunch of old, gassed out chumps trying to throw elbows at the Y Saturday mornings. Yeah, that's fair. I would allow that. They did. And you knew it right from the very jump. Dear West Coast, Boom. Out of here. Sign Baylor. Scott in San Antonio, non-crier. There's a lot of that, and there's not much I can say about that either, other than it's right. It's true. They were that good last night. Gonzaga, tell me how my ass tastes. Regards, Baylor. JP in Riverside, War Angels fan, throwing trash cans on the field at the Houston Astros. I will get to that as well. They were lobbing debris onto the field. And by debris, I mean trash cans. Rome, Zags sought perfection, and they certainly found it, just not on their side. Jack from Grand Rapids, right? We knew that there was going to be a juggernaut last night. We just picked the wrong juggernaut. Hey, Rome, congrats to Baylor on winning the national championship. Question, though, who was that Division III team that they were playing? What did I just say, Lee? What did I just say about coming up in here and saying that Gonzaga was overrated? They played a bullcrap conference, and they got exposed. None of it's true. I'm not saying it's the best conference. Far from it. But that's not why they got beaten down last night. You want to know why they got beat down last night? Because Baylor is better. Baylor is really good. Really deep. Really athletic. Really aggressive. Really tough. And they play tremendous defense, and they've got three unbelievable guards, and they've got a really good bench. And a kooky but really good coach. Boy, how about Scott Drew's act afterwards, man? That was almost worth the price of admission.